So hello and welcome to the Mountain Bike Eliminator World Cup here in Aalen in Germany. We are here for round number four. My name's Matt Payne and I'm going to be bringing you all of the action from this amazing town, famed for its half-timbered houses built between the 16th and the 18th century. Some amazing features have been built here on site. You see our bubbles, we've got our double truck, it's an entry and a drop down, and the course has been catching our riders out, not just our mini Strada Bianchi, this is a proper Strada Bianchi with its jump, but also of course that final jump into the finish, and that's seen a lot of action already. We're going to jump straight in with our quarterfinals. As you can see, we have Gaia Tormena, fastest qualifier, our world champion in heat number one, and we're going to be watching them in action. So you can see Gaia there, second from the left. So we did the De Vries, Gaia Tormena. We've got well the three riders tucked in on that start line. They'll go on the sound of the whistle from the commissaire team, our race referees, who's going to take the top spot as they go off from the line. Watch out for Tormena. She's on blistering form at the moment. So away they go, and we are going to see who's got that kick seat. Tormena in those World Championship strikes straight into the first of these jumps. It's a big double. They've got to get this right. Steps down. So rather than stepping up, you've got to step down. If you jump it, you've got to land on that smaller ramp. You've got to just jump off the side. And at the moment, Tormena in the front in those World Champion colours, just opening up the gap. This is the Eliminator, so two of our riders in each of our will go through, and at the moment it's Didi De Vries, as you can see, under pressure in position two behind. The pressure is coming on behind Flavio Julie going in at the back. There, De Vries, and as you can see, as they come out and round, they're going to come into the wall right. Some great artwork here in Aalen, as you can see, Tormena going up, and look. Me, Freddy in trouble at the moment because Flavi is pushing on the back of Diddy's back wheel there, and we know with two riders through, the critical fight is that fight for second and third place. But don't anything riders go through the line. We have seen broken chains, broken bikes, and broken people on the way in and to our quarterfinals. Our riders qualify by going through the time trial and attempt until we get to a maximum of 16 riders in our quarterfinals. And this in quarterfinal heat number one, it is the world champion, Gaia Tormena, who has had a relatively quiet social media affair. And that's because she's been focusing on getting the training absolutely spot on for this. This course, as you can see, off from the Strada Bianchi doubles into this really narrow street. The crowd's packed at the side for round number four here in Aalen. And you can see as they go up, we climb up, but then it is a drop down into the wall right now. Tormena just going around the lower section there, carrying plenty of speed. Here you can just see this final jump up here. It takes some speed off. They're going to be side by side coming in. Tormena goes through. Will it be De Vries? He looks to me like De Vries is going to qualify. So Gaia going through with De Vries confirmed in second place, and eliminated is going to be Flavio Jouy, who is going to do now to watch from, well, if you can find a spot on the barriers at this side of the course and watch the rest of the action. Now on to the second of our quarterfinals, we have Shrivers, Becky and Stocker lined up of these riders. Esther Berecki very, very quick. Shriver very fast indeed. So will it be a Shriver, the rider with that number four plate, indicative of where they qualified in the time trial? The rider a third from the left there goes off and away. So you can just see Shriver is up in the lead. She's got this move, and we've had a big stack already. We said there were thrills and spills. Now riders generally jumping back up on the bike, but that double, you jump up and in. If you get that wrong, you land short, you're in big trouble. And that has opened up a gap between second and third place at the moment, with our fourth place rider a long way back. So you can just see major problems on that attack going up and over. They're in here on lap number two, laps in each of our races. And at the moment, It is Leah Schreiber. Schreiber's who is leading out at the moment. The question is, can Schreiber take this away? So Schreiber's a very quick rider. We know that she can really push the top rider. She's currently sitting fourth in the series standings. And the rider from Bayeth from Germany, Kurt, continues go through the line. And look at that. You can just see she's keeping it very smooth at the moment. We're looking to see who's going to come through. So Amon van Diest is in at second place. And it was Stocker who went for that flyer over the handlebars on lap number one. But just to watch it on course, I think Stocker is in one piece, even if at the moment she's not in full. So all of our riders back up and racing, but the battle really is between first and second for honor, because they are going to go through smoothly. And this is where the riders have to be smart. We said this, if you've watched the shows before, you've eliminated about conserving energy. When you know that you are clear in the qualifying spots, backing off the pace and keeping clear of the riders behind. Now we can just see Becky, the Romanian rider, really is trying to squeeze back and push on to the back wheels, but time is running out for Becky. Really bolts by the attack and collapse over the step down as they come up onto that. It's going to be Alia Schreiber at home in Germany, who's going to take away the win in that heat. So Alia Schreiber goes through a sub 1 minute round, 57 for the first qualifier in first qualifying lap. The second lap completed a little bit longer, 2:04. Now watch this start. You can see Berecki on the left hand side, Stocker on the right in the green and white. She jumps into this, but then too much pressure on those bars. The kicker coming up, she didn't get that nailed, and that is a big, big problem. Now, very fast riders in our third quarterfinal. Bossy Atos Homeguard. And we also have, of course, Boise in here. So at the moment, our riders are continuing to push as they go through. We are currently getting kick off from the line by Matos. Matos is looking smooth as she goes off from the straight at the moment. So Matos and working well. Let's see if she can hold on to this lead. So at the moment, our race leader going clear. Let's see how she gets on in this heat. Let's watch them around this course. Around the here, our race leader is Matos. You saw as she came around those corners, she really does have a command of the race here, and it certainly looks to me like that race lead is hers to take in to the finish. The question will be, who is going to take away the time as they come in? Ella Homeguard in second place, watching the wheels behind. See, will it be Homeguard who comes in to the stand section behind the rider you're seeing at the moment? That is a Matos. So here we go, Matos looking good. Homeguard watching her wheels, watching to see who's going to go around her. Will it be Abramson who come around? The rider with that number 10 on the back from Sweden. The two riders are moving fast. So let's see how they go. It is Leolite Homeguard's got that down. Matos comes through, the rider who took the World Club lead in round number one, clear at the front of the race, and certainly looking in the back. So here we go. You can see Matos lead round of the turn. Looking at that line behind, you can just see Holmgaard really is in control. She lands it smoothly up on the top now. Let's watch them as they come in towards the bike. Holmgaard lands slight angle. I think that put her off just a little bit coming in and through. So at the moment, certainly looking good. And as we move into our fourth quarter final, it is going to be Fromme who is lined up here. So our fourth one is the Selina Fromme. We've got Fromberger, Anklesjur, and Kuiper. Now the right up is the black. That is Marion Fromberger. So we can certainly looking smooth as these riders come in and through. There is nothing to choose between as they go up and over, but at the moment it is Fromberger who has the head. This is getting out to Fromberger, not losing this. Let's see if that's going to be the case as they go around this lap number one here. So look at this, we can see at the moment Fromberger just losing a little bit of ground as he came through those sessions now into this wall ride. That gap is not at the moment. So Colleen Closure and Fromberger, the two riders expected to figure in this, with Fromberger third, Closure in sixth position. Over they go. You can just see Fromberger leading this out. Let's watch what happens as they make their way around lap number two. Our riders moving smoothly around this course, looking good at the moment, and certainly it seems to me like these riders know exactly how to ride the course. There's no problems at all from them as they make their way up and over the top of the course, looking very, very smooth at the moment and no issues at all. Look at that, we're going for the high fives on a route. So here we go, Fromberger, Closure, and everybody is moving super smooth. So as you can see, Fromberger going through there as we see our results, our qualifiers going through. It is Guy Tomedes, Vries, Leah Shrivers, and Moon van Deest, Marcela Lima Matos, Ella Holmgaard, Baron Fromberger, and Colleen Closure going through. We're going to move on to our men's competition next. So here we go, our riders are lined up, our quarterfinals men, quarterfinal number one, lined and ready here. So quarterfinals number one for the men. You can see at the moment, so we've got Calvin. He's the rider who is the rider fastest time in that time trial, all in the black with that number one plate, and away they go. So here we are, our riders are moving very, very fast indeed, and it certainly looks like they are absolutely flying out of that stargate. So it is our fastest man in the time trial, Thibaut Kalhoven, who goes in to the obstacles first through the truck. So in and around those turns they go. You can just see Cal Hubbard at the moment. He's absolutely flying. The riders are moving very, very quick. So you can just see just how fast these riders can take this course when they really put the mind to it. And when that racing is tight, remember, two riders are through. So this is an incredibly fast time. This is very fast up and over the section there. The riders have got to land that smoothly. That's where we saw Simon Gegenheim in one of our qualifiers that have issues as he landed, but no problems for the race leaders. But positions 2 to 3 are very, very tight indeed. This is incredibly close. So look at this, it is very fast, it's very close, it's very, very tight, and it certainly looks to me like this is going to be about who can keep cool, calm, and cool. We've got Carl Hoven riding with the number one plate, Bellmare is the number eight place, Castillo Noyolo with a 24 plate, and Nils Obed Ricca with that 17. At the moment, it's going down to that sprint. Who is going to get eliminated out? You can just see the frustration there. We wait for the confirmation. It's showing that it is going to be Carl Hoven and Rika who go through. So here we go. Campaign Gagne Ham. And the world champion on home turf here, Simon Gegenheimer, looking absolutely superb in practice. But then you can see the damage to elbow. So let's see what happens as he goes on. That was done on the very last jump back into the finishing line on the time trial where he overjumped it. He landed on the very last section of the down ramp and that cost him big, big, big problems. So here we go. Riders are set and ready to ride. Gegenheimer looking very cool, calm and composed on the right hand side. Now, the rest of the riders wants to watch out for key man. Tichuan Perrin-Gagne, the rider second from the left, fourth fastest qualifier. He's got the number four. Gegenheimer has the 29 plate on. Either side of them, we've got Kyle Cameron with the 12 plate and Florian Ham with the 21 plate. Remember those plate numbers, it tell you where they finish there. Well, Gegenheimer finishing with time in 29th, even though he had that crash. So here we go. It is into this first jump down. All of four riders just get that nailed as they come down. And the former world champion is challenging the current world champion. Now, Gegenheimer has the lead. Look at third and fourth places here. Bigman side. Oh, they nearly take each other out. It's coming around that corner. This is so, so close. So having another mistake on the way in there. So Cameron, along with Ham, are tangling like crazy. And this is what's caused some problems. And it is Kyle Cameron who's been posted unceremonious to the gravel here. Then it has left the door open. And you can just see those bars twisted right the way around. And I think a little bit of a limp there from Cameron. I'm sure it'll be okay. He's up and carrying the bikes. Can't be too bad. Over. Now up and drop back down again. And Perrin-Gagne makes a move on the inside here. He doesn't want to be the rider under pressure in second place. Gegenheimer moves up a little bit here. Interesting. A little bit sketchy there, I think, from Perrin-Gagne as they went up and over. So Perrin-Gagne leading at the moment, the French champion and, of course, former world champion. And looking good at the moment. So here we go. They are making the way in and through. And at the moment, it is Perrin-Gagne who is ahead of Heimer. They are pushing hard at the moment. But you can just see these riders having no problems at all as they go up and over these options. And certainly looks to me like this is going to be a very, very interesting as they come in and through. Let's see who is going to take this away. It is going to come down to seeing who has the control pace, who has the speed as they go up and over. And it's Perrin-Gagne and Gegenheimer who will go through. Ham taking third place, eliminated out of this round. So far, about getting most of our riders around in one piece, but this is why we love the Eliminator. Now, the start is usually the most critical part of the course on this route, though. There are so many obstacles. You can just see that they're just coming in and losing the grip on the front wheel. That left the way clear with Ham chasing the former and current world champion. So, take the left turn. We have got on the left side a very fast ride by Gegenheimer. And now you can just see we have the stuff is Eric Fierro. He's just had to be patched up. You can just see that brace on his right arm. But Fierro, very fast indeed from Ecuador. He's going down that right-hand side. Going to go into this ramp. Almost three riders side by side. They land it. I think Fierro just lost his belt. He's lost his chain. You can see him banging all his bars in frustration. I think the chain came off or jammed on the landing. One of the riders got to keep it so smooth on the way around. So again, another incident in the middle of the race as they come in and through. So our riders continue to push here in Aalen for the UCI Mountain Bike Eliminator World Cup. We have had our women's quarterfinals. We're on to the third of our men's quarterfinals. And at the moment, you can just see the gap is opening up a bit. The first rider coming through, that is Quinton Schrotzenberger. So Schrotzenberger leading this out with that number two plate on the second fastest in the battle. Eric Fierro is just trying to make sure he can keep going round and keep out of the way, but Schrotzenberger absolutely going skywards there like a rocket off that step down jump. Basically big ramp on the smaller one as you can. Here we go, Schrotzenberger looking super smooth. And under pressure, he's arrived with that number seven plate. That is Julian Claudi. We thought Fierro was going to challenge. He's not at the moment because he was eliminated with that problem on the landing. And it looks to me like we're going to see a great ride hit the German right home turf. Who's going to be thinking? Because it looks to me we're going to see Schrotzenberger go through from France there, but immediately beside him, you can see him punching the air. Claudi goes through from just second of our qualifiers in the quarterfinal, the third quarterfinal. Fantastic to see as they make their way around the course here. Now let's watch Fierro's came in. He loses. He has a far side, he goes over. That landing looks pretty clean, but no drive on the way through. Schrotzenberger going quickly through the Strada Bianchi section. I think this is where we saw that loss on Loic. Now, on to our final of the race of the quarter of finals coming in, and this is going to be interesting. We've got Zinnik van Looy, it's Felix Klausman. You can just see van Looy there with a 27 plate. Klausman has the 30 plate, both beaten by Stefan Mayer with the 11 plate, and of course you've seen Stocker with the 13 plate. They beat the two big favourites in Van Looy and Klausman in at the finish. So who is going to take this away? Let's see who has got the, as they got on the line, big kick coming out. Klausman traditionally a super fast starter, the German showing why he's so tough to beat off the line that time. He's got the inside line here now. He's going to want to move over a little bit to get that truck in prime position. It looks like he's done that, and it does mean that at the moment Zinnik van Looy has been pushed right to the back of the group. Now we were talking to him a little bit before the start of the program. He said he was far time trial, qualify well, and this is showing that the pace is a very, very hot here today, because van Looy has been incredibly quick before. Not at the moment. He's position four. He's got to move up on the very front of the race, though. Klausman has used that start, and you just see that exit from the wall ride. He's a little sketchy. Oh, and you can see it was in there. There are one or two sketchy moments as they come down onto the landing. That's where Gegenheimer went off as he was racing earlier on. So this is really, really, really weird. Let's have a little bit of and see just how these riders can deal with this. These are the best riders in the world racing in the race at the moment. So you can just see the riders in the race are racing here in the final of the quarterfinals. But this is amazing. It's fantastic to see that they are coming out and round so fast. And at the moment, Klausmann is in. But look at riders 2 and 3 here. That's Meyer and Stocker in that order as they come along and down this straight in towards the finish. So this is where we go. We've got about this sprint. They've got to land this cleanly. Really interesting to see. I think Stocker thinks it's out of this. He is now. It is Meyer who goes through behind Klausmann. They're going to be our two qualifiers. Brave battle there by Michael Stocker, but not be his day today. Neither the day for Zinnie van Looy. Just see van Looy by the right next to our cameras, doesn't get the cleanest start, and by the time we're partway around the race, he's in position 4, not a position we would expect to see. So let's see just these riders continue to push onwards here. It is going to be really, really quick. So let's take a little bit of a look as they come dropping down. So here we go. You can see our qualifiers on the way through. So here we go to our semi-finals. Amazing ride so far, and it is the world champion that we expect to lead out at semi-final number one. We've got the rider who really handed it to the very first round, but since has been struggling with Marcelo de Matos after. Now, let's have a little look. Van Deinst, Tormeno, Shrivers, and De Vries all are fighting for their position. Riders through, two riders eliminated, and it is Gaia Tormeina who leads them out on to the first of these jumps. Now, getting this right is critical. We saw issues in the finals. We're now into the semi-finals. Three riders clear at the front of the race as they go through. You can just see the pace of Gaia Tormeina is really clear, and she's got the gap. It's not insurmountable at this stage in proceedings. The question will be clear the gap, the start line, fractions of a second, but it is enough. And at the moment at the back, you just see Didi's Reese in fourth position here, looking like she's not going to be able to push up into contention. Guy is clear immediately behind Tormeina. You can see that the riders are trying to close it down, but it looks to me like Leah Shrivers has the best spot here. She's in position 2 of those chasing riders. So Shrivers at the moment from De Vries and Van Deinst, they've got to answer this. They need to go through in the top 2 places. Let's watch this track. It's been extremely exciting so far. So looking through, we have Gaia Tormeina into the Bianchi type. It's compacted gravel, it's whacker plated down as it's known, and it's compressed down to give us very hard and a very fast takeoff. So Gaia Tormeina comes through the lead, Leah Shrivers behind, and the German rider immediately behind them. You can just see that Anna Moon van Deinst has got the better of Didi De Vries, but she's got to challenge her, and I'm not sure what she can do as she comes around this corner. We've got one more big seen incidents here before as they come up. You can see a little bit of a push here from Anna Moon van Deinst. She's trying to continue that pace in, but Shrivers, she kicks in and over the line. So it's Tormeina, Shrivers who are going to go through into our main final. The rest of the riders will go into the minor finals. We have our minor final for positions 8th, 7th, 6th, and 5th. A medal for the way down. Now, this start is critical. You can just see that the power and the pace of Gaia Tormeina coming out of the blocks is incredible. It gives her that lead. And from there, it really is for her to lose the race lead, and that was something she didn't do on the way through. This is really a key as she makes her way around this course. She has to keep this absolutely nailed on as she comes in and through. And at the moment, it certainly looks to me like it is going to be a very fast finish. Now, in the second of our semi-finals, this could be very close indeed. Marcela Lima Matos from Brazil, the rider with the number two plate, on back on form. Not a great round last time out, but amazing on the first two rounds. And of course, leader as we left Abu Dhabi. This is going to be closer, and you can just see from the kickoff there that Colleen Clajure from France going in, but what a mistake. Just see just how hard the feature is. It has opened the door here for Marion Fromberger on home turf to go into the lead. So now Fromberger is leading from Matos, and Clajure's issues there with Matos. We'll get a replay hopefully later as we see them come through. It means we've got a real battle, and the rider who has been pushed into fourth place, it is going to be Holmgaard, who is the rider come down the straight. So they're going to have to come in and take this left-hand turn. They get in and around it, and you can just see Holmgaard at the moment in fourth position. The round slap is Fromberger in one, in two, it's Clajure, who's gone back round Matos once again. Matos does not like that feature. She goes up and over. And you can just see Fromberger really is the rider in the control. So Fromberger in one, in two, it's going to be Clajure. In three is Matos. And in fourth place at the moment, it's going to be Ella Holmgaard, the Swedish. Not maybe on the form that we saw her. She was on home turf in the previous round and has been really strong in the preceding rounds. But Fromberger clearly inspired here. One of the city of Aalen, and looks like it's inspiring her in that all-black outfit to continue to push on here. Now she'll want to take the points. Remember, two riders go through into the main final, the other two drop down into the minor final in our semi-finals. At the moment, Matos, the rider who took the in the very first round at Abu Dhabi, the scorching heat, she's the rider at the moment who's going to be pushed down into the minor final. She was leading the World Cup after that first round. She carried it on through, but she's unable to make it stick here today. And Fromberger once again looking amazing as she goes through. Good to see Clajure back up to form. Again, they are going to be our two qualifiers. So amazing riding here with Tormina Schreves, Fromberger and Clajure going through. And you can see this is where that error was. It was just buried in the trees, and it was a mistake by Matos. I think Clajure just bulking her on the way into that climb. And then Matos getting that wrong as we see our crew quickly moving the dancers out of the way. This is what we love about the city mountains. All happening, there's all sorts of action. It's not just your traditional mountain bike obstacles to get around on the way around the race circuit. Now you can just see that Matos there in third place in the white from Brazil. Happy she's not in the final, but look at Fromberger. She comes in and through. She's got the time to coast in and through, but pushed all the way. And I think both of our race leaders may say maybe a little bit of an title. Schreves through with Marion Fromberger and Colleen Clajure. Amarun van Deister, Diddy de Vries, and Marcelina Lima Matos and Ella Holmgaard are out. So our riders are lined up and ready. Here in Aalen, we have our two semi-finals. The question is, who will go through? Two through from each heat, going on and out from there. So will it be Rika Perengane, a Kinheimer, the world champion, lined up on the far right-hand side of our screen? Left-hand side for the riders, not the optimum spot going through. Titian Perrin Garnier goes up on there, but he's knocked them off. They come up and over the top there. You can see it is the man who took the number one plate. I think that's going to be Carl Hoven, who is going to lead them round. It is so at the moment. The rider who had that start time trial currently leading out, Nils Hoven. Rika is the rider currently in fourth position, so as to go over the top. We can see it is looking very, very quick as they go up over the top course here. And it's certainly going to be a very quick race here because we still have four riders in contention. So over the top they go. You can just see massive kick as they come down and in. And at the moment it is a very, very fast indeed as they go in through. It certainly looks to me like we're going to have a real battle with Tetuan Peregagne now being pushed back, but Gegenheim, who knows this course inside out, is really starting to push here. Will he be able to continue this pace? Will he be able to continue to push? It's going to be a very, very fast finish. The two world champions so fast here, and it looks to me like the rider who put that fast time trial is paying for that early effort. He's dropped back. Nils Obedbricka is with him now. So third and fourth place together. The first and second place are together. As they go up and around, this is going to be very, very tight indeed as they come in and through. So who is going to take this? Who is going to be the rider who put away well? It was close on the line. Who has got that as they go through? Peregagne just taking that from Gegenheimer, just on the line, but very, very close between our two riders there. So as our riders have finished that, the first of our semi-finals, you can just take a little bit of a look back and watch this. See a Gegenheimer on the left-hand side, not getting the start he wanted, but the fast start by the rider who got that number one plate. That is Thibaut Kalhoven. Kalhoven really quick at the time, not able to match his pace as they come in. And the two world champions, the past world champion on the left and the current world champion on the right, both coming through very quick. We have four riders, Klasman, Claudi, Schrotzenberg, and Meyer. These are the riders who are now lined up in the second of our semi-finals. Of them, Klasman, that you can see there with the third plate left-hand side, and Schrotzenberg, the third rider from the left, expects to be the ones to figure. Will they be the ones who can make this count as they go through? It is about that quick start of Klasman. Hit on this course, he's certainly going, oh, down he goes. Oh, what a problem. He landed it on the front wheel, he overjumped it. It's a fast start, but too fast for Klasman as he went down there. That is not what you need to see. There's the riders in and through. You can just see as they come up and over. It has left the race in pieces because we've had a massive change around. It's going to be Meyer, I think, who's going to come leading them through here. It is Stefan Meyer who has prime spot, and it has allowed a Schrotzenberger a little bit of an easier run, I think, because I think Klasman would have pushed him, but he hasn't got up and over the jump. And that was disastrous for the German on home turf. He overjumped it. He landed pretty much on the front wheel. He couldn't hold it together as he went down and went over the bars. Amazing that the riders managed to dodge it, but he's now left this race wide open as they come down and in. So here we go, the riders up over the top of that jump. They're almost side by side. This is going to be a game of chicken into the ramp. Oh, are they going to come out in one piece? It was side by side coming in, and it's Meyer who comes out in the lead. He's got Schrotzenberger on his wheel. Now, can we see Julian Claudi, the rider who was maybe a surprise coming through from the quarterfinal, moving up, tying out for him to make at the junction. As they come down the straight, you can just see the lead is with Schrotzenberger in the blue with that number two plate. Immediately behind him is Meyer with the yellow jersey and the blue back. Then in the all black is Julian Claudi, the second of our German riders in and along. But will he be able to push up? He's got to try and push out a countryman. They're going to be side by side. Oh, it's so tight on the line. That's going to come down to the judges' finish. And I think, wow, it's Meyer who is shown who has taken that. So it is going to be Steph. And according to the timing screens, it's by 0.02 of a second as they came through. Now, watch this start by Klasman. He goes in incredibly quickly into this jump. What a landing. As he comes down, it's all about this landing here. Front wheel lands, it lands on the lip between the down ramp, the landing ramp and the cobbles, and there's just nowhere left to go at that, and that's what cost him the race, because he would surely have been one of the favorites to come in. Now the sprint finish into the line was so close. I think Schrotzenberger maybe eased off a little early there. He was fortunate to go away in second, so it's Meyer and Schrotzenberger who go through. Cloudy was only 0.07 of a second back as they came in and through, and that really shows you just how tight this racing is. So Perrin-Gagné, Gegenhammer, Meyer and Schrotzenberger in and through. We are going to be moving on fairly quickly, I think, on to our next races. We have our minor and our major finals, so the small and the big finals. So the small final is Marcelin Lima Matos and co in the small final for the women, and the rest of that race field for the men. The guys and Quinton Schrotzenberger heading up the finals. So in we go. Into the small home garden yellow, in the white with the green Matos, then Van Diest in the black with the red stripes on the sleeves. Will it be a Matos? Who's the rider expected to figure here? She has her work cut out, because we know that Didi De Vries can also challenge. All four of these riders more than capable of taking the win here today at round four. Ella Holmgaard putting a big squeeze on Matos, and that has caused problems. I think Matos has gone down into the barrier. She is, so Matos eliminated out of that race, and the commissaires at Rafa Cerise will be looking at that line. They are fairly flexible when taking a line into the jump, but that was very, very close indeed. So very interesting, these riders coming in and through. So let's see who is going to take this. So here we go. The riders at the moment are pushing the way in and round the course, and we can just see that after the early issues there, it has totally shaken up the race. Issues with Matos is going to have taken it out of contention as they come around that corner. You can just see that Holmgaard is currently in third place. De Vries cut is another close call as they come down that ramp. Jumping onto a step down is always tricky. The landing is blind. You've got to get it nailed, and that didn't happen that time around. But it looks to me like it was a escape at that time as it came down from Amund Van Diest as she landed that. So Van Diest leading, but De Vries in second, Holmgaard in third place in the race. That corresponds to fifth, sixth and seventh overall in the competition if the positions were to stay as they are. But on this really tricky track here in Aalen, it's going to be very interesting to see just who is going to take this out. Who will be the rider who takes a victory here today? So here we go, big kick on the way in. You can just see that we have Van Diest coming through ahead of De Vries. It's going to be Holmgaard. So it looks like that is going to be our three riders on the way through. To him, our riders on the way in to the straight, and you can just see what that action, what the problem was. Holmgaard just clipping the side of Matos. Here we go, you can just see that pace coming in. It's coming through fast here, and it certainly looks to me like those three will go through. The question will Holmgaard be given that as she comes in and through? Now, we're gonna move on to the men's here. We have Claudia Rico, Cal Hoven, and Klausman. They're racing for the positions 5, 6, 7, and 8. Who will it be? Who's gonna take this? It's going to be really interesting to see, because we have people who've been laid on that floor on this track. Will it be the rider lined up there, Nils Omedrika, on the left of your Great. Was the rider who was taken out of that race really by the actions of the others. But will Klaus be able to get over that first obstacle? He's certainly going to take some pace off, I think, but he can't take too much seat on this start. He's gone into fourth position this time round. He's taken the left-hand line, which is the safer line. Now he puts a kick in, and that has moved him up from last into second place. Maybe a slightly more circumstanced way to take position, but a safer one, and that is good for Klausman here. So here we go, around that left-hand turn. Klausman in second wheel. He's continuing to push. It's the man who took the top spot in the time trial who is leading the race out at the moment, and that is going to be Thibaut Kalhoven. So it's Kalhoven from Klausman. And immediately behind, all of these riders are continuing to push onwards, but it is going to be about those positions. It's not about who's second or third, who's going to be in the cutoff. It's straight for the win. And at the moment, it looks to me like the battle is going to be as a movie's made by on the hand side of the course here. So Klausman pushes on here. This is going to be Klausman pushing. He's got the race lead. Can he hold it together up over the jump? He can, but he loses a little bit of ground. And you can see a move coming on the side here. And that is Nils Obed Rieker who's come around the side. So Rieker who is trying to close that gap down now. So it is Nils Obed Rieker in second position. And it looks to me like a Calvin. The third place, the rider who has got pushed back out of a contention here. So this is going to be all about that battle. Who can take this? Will it be Klausman? The minor final as they come into these final stages. You can see them just coming over the top of the cobbles on that thinner section. They're going to come into the wall ride with one big jump over the top. Here we go. This is going to be about that final kick into the line. Klausman takes it. He's going to be pleased with that, even though he wasn't in the final. Nils Obed Rieker comes through immediately behind him. Then is going to be Thibaut Kalhoven. Kalhoven goes over the top there in third place in that race. And I think Julian Clodi will take that final spot, the eighth place going in. Await those positions confirming. And gotta say, amazing racing so far here today. Great to see so many people watching the racing. And you could just see the move by Klausman in the white in that German national jersey. He waited to make his move until it was safe to do so. Always a good move when you're out on the bike. And it paid off for Klausman, not overlooking the jump, not getting it wrong that time around. And that meant that he was in prime spot coming into that final kick, where realistically, with the kick that Klausman has, that was not going to be the case. And that Nils Obed Rieker very happy with his second place in that minor final. Now, on to our women's final. Colleen Closure on the left. Then we have Marion Fromberger along with Leah Shriver. So Closure, the French champion, very, very fast rider indeed. Can she take on the world champion, European champion, and the national champion, Gaia Tormena? And of course, Fromberger has been one of the few riders who can take that top spot from Tormena. And Leah Shivers is definitely on a rich form on home ground. Who will have the fast start? Remember, Tormena in the World Champions jersey, currently leading that World Cup by a substantial margin, almost double the points of everybody else. Has it to lose now. She will want to get this series sewn up as early as she can. She needs maximum points to do that, and she needs to continue that, not just here, but into the later round. So they're poised and ready to go. Who will get the fastest start? They're ready. Going to be from this line. The reaction comes, and it looks like a very quick start from Closure and the French colours there on the right-hand side. Tormena almost overjumping it, but nails the landing. So Tormena in one, from Berger in two. Then it's Closure in three, and they are being followed by De Vries in four as they go through those trucks and drop down back onto the cobbles. On to our Strada Bianchi-esque type of jumps, very similar to a pump track or similar that you find in trail centers around the world here as they take this right-hand turn. Tormena is looking very focused, but look at Bomber. She's not giving up on that back wheel of the world champion. She's closing in on it every time she puts the pressure down. She's going to try and pressurize Tormena. I think it's making a mistake. Not sure how to go around it, but if there is a mistake, it's going to show. They're almost side by side as they come up over towards the end of this lap. Here we go. So let's make the turn and let's see just who is going to move. Oh, and a mistake by Fromberg. Again, that landing. You can just see the problems that these riders have. With that down jump where they've got to get the pace and the speed right, once they're under pressure, then that's when they're making mistakes. It's left the door wide open. It's going to mean that Gaia Torben is going to not need to take any risks on the way through. She's going to take a clear top spot here. The world champion being brought home by these huge crowds here at the XCE. The Mountainbike Eliminator just showing all of these crowds, all of these spectators and everybody watching just how exciting the racing can be on what is an incredibly tough course. Now, can she make it back safely? She goes over, pushing a little bit of pace. Oh, she's going to have time to celebrate in style here. The world champion takes the race of victory. It's going to be a German second place here with Olivia driving away second place. That's not the rider we thought who is likely to be challenged after that problem for Fromberger on the landing. And Colleen Clojure is going to take third place. So away go the riders, absolutely leaping this nailed. And I think you can just see exactly how smoothly we are getting the riders to Tormena. So Gaia Tormena, a great race victory. I think we can get through.
This one was very tough because I wasn't feeling really well before the semi-final. Then the feelings was better and better. And I'm super happy to win here in Aalen with such a crowd. It's incredible.
It's incredible. They are crazy.
Yeah. And this is the show we really would like to have everywhere.
Okay, thank you, Gaia Tormena. Congratulations.
Well, great to hear from Gaia Tormena there. And as she said, the crowds are crazy there. And a game victory at 4.6 seconds. Colleen Clojure taking third place at 9.35 behind. And we've got to feel very sorry for Fromberg making that mistake, landing it wrongly on the descent down. 26.91 seconds down, but going over the line, it does mean that she is in one piece. So amazing riding. And as we can see, our riders making their way on to the podiums here and receiving the flowers. So the fist bumps from our riders in second and third place. Walsall, eighth place here at round number four for Colleen Clojure, second place for Leah Shivers, the race of victor, the world champion Gaia Tormena, the race winner in the finals here at Football Needle. Great. As we move to our men's competition, Simon Gegenheimer on the left of your screen, the current world champion, Titouan Perengani, second rider from the left, third across is going to be Quinton Schrotzenberger, and then of course we have Stefan Mayer, a surprise finalist for some, but going to be interesting. He's been very, very consistent all the way through the racing. So let's see who is going to take this out, who is going to take a race victory. Going to be interesting to see just who has the power to take this away. So here we go. We have Simon Gegenheimer, the current world champion, the current World Cup leader. He is clear of Titouan Perengani. He needs to push on though, because he will want to close the gap down from Perengani to Gegenheimer. Gegenheimer is currently only 18 points in front. Rotzenberg going to be right up through the standings with this finals ride. He just needs to finish in one piece, of course. And then we have Mayer, who is going to amass far more points. He's got a far bigger to see him move right up those rankings. But the battle for the series lead is between the two riders on the left of your screen. But they all want race victory here. They've seen what's happened. Some of them have been on the floor before. They need to keep this nailed. Watch carefully. Let's see who gets the start. And will they be too quick off from the line? Away they go. So who's going to have the pace and the power? Berengania goes in. Almost a breath coming in over the top. Aren't they nailed? So no mistakes on lap number one by Berengania or Gegenheimer. They are the 1-2 coming in. Mayer's in third place. Fourth place is currently going to be Schrossenberg. Going to have to pull as they make their way down the straight here. And over those sand jumps, it really is compacted gravel rather than sand. And that means that if you get it wrong, it's really going to hurt. But all of our riders get dialed this time round now into that left-hand turn. You can see just how close Gegenheimer is riding to the back of Berengania. It's a risky option. You don't want to let the gap go far because you could be dropped and distanced. But if you go too close and there's a mistake, then you're going to be right on him. And particularly if you overjump and land too far down the jump, it'd be very easy to land on the back wheel of the rider in front. Around that corner, you see the pace and the speed they're carrying. Now they go over to the right-hand side. It's that risky line. You can see just how quick this is. Berengania goes in to the trucks first, then it is Gegenheimer. They're taking this left-hand turn. Here we go. It's going to be super, super fast. Who has got the speed? Who has got the pace? Go over the top of the sand. Berengania, you're leading this out at the moment. Where will get try and make a move? Has he got the pace to go around Berengania? Berengania has a phenomenal sprint. He's got lots of power, but so has Gegenheimer. It could come down to the very last obstacle. Remember, Gegenheimer crashed on that last obstacle when he was on his time trial. Is that going to put him off? Berengania comes in hot. He just about holds it. He's going to lead this out. Gegenheimer comes on the side. It comes down to the line. Who took it? I don't know who's got it. It's Gegenheimer. Simon Gegenheimer on the home ground. The world champion just pips Berengania to the line by 0.04 of a second. Is how close it is. I don't think that's a rubber knobble on the tire. You can see what it means to our riders. Simon Gegenheimer, race victor in the final race of the day for the AE. And look at that. The crowd got absolutely ballistic behind him. And you've got to feel particularly Berengania leading all that time, but not quite having the to take it out. And new fan clubs are there. There were actually bus loads of fans coming to the event today, both for Simon Gegenheimer and for Marion Fromberger. They were disappointed after Fromberger's race, I'm sure, because she would be expected to be right up there. But Simon Gegenheimer takes the victory. Wow, what a finish, and that's what we love about XC. It's close, it's physical, and guess what? It's going to be tight between the riders. Look at the kickoff from here. Really, the two riders who were in it from the start were Berengania and Gegenheimer. Mayer, and along with Sundberger, battled it out behind for position. But you can just see Berengania looking like he had this coming into the final. But Gegenheimer came on the outside. At 0.04 of a second between the riders as they came in and over the line. An amazing result there for Simon Gegenheimer, taking the race victory. Very, very pleased with that. And I think we're going to be able to hear from him, who's he's down just about getting his breath back at the moment, just down by our.
Simon, like 10 meters before the finish line, I thought the win is for T2R, but what a finish jump.
Yeah, I knew about the final straight that it's long, and I waited really for the finish. I was so all the race close on his wheel to wait for that moment. It was hard, it was really the last meter. I changed it, but it's hard.
And the last part was a little bit uphill, so a little bit tricky.
Exactly, it was harder than it looks because it was an uphill, because it was after a jump. But yeah, I waited really for that moment.
We were a little bit scared after the time trials where you hit yourself, you know, you hurt yourself, but in the end, it turned out well.
Yeah, for sure. Then I was also a bit out of focus. So much spectators all cheer for me. I was maybe a bit too motivated, but maybe even the crash helps in the end. But yeah, all the people around, they pushed me to the win.
So
the
what a crowd.
Yeah, what a crowd. The win is for them. It's my 10th, the jubileum, the anniversary of my World Cup wins. It's the 3rd in a row. I'm really, really happy.
Congratulations. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Well, great to hear from the man whose face is up on the banner behind the race. So, time again, a time of 142.26.04 behind it to Emperin Garnier. And then a great third place from Quentin Schrotzenberger. But you can see Schrotzenberger and Mayer busy each third and fourth places. Amazing racing here at Aalen, and looking forward to seeing our riders now. Yes, you can see we have Quinton Strassenberg here, takes away place. It's second place for the former world champion, Titouan Perrin-Gagnier from France. But it is a race victory for Simon Gegenheimer, celebrating all Boise's fans afterwards and taking centre stage here. So Simon Gegenheimer, your winner of round number 4, Perrin-Gagnier in second, and Quinton Strassenberger in third place. So at the end of, you can see the preliminary World Cup standings have Gegenheimer extending his lead, came in with an 18-point lead. He's now at 25 points clear, and behind Schrotzenberger, moving right up through the standings. He's been able to push almost in terms of the women. Well, Gaia Tormena once again adding a massive point, so to take a clear from Berger, now moving 6 points of Matos. But both Fromberger and Matos, I think, will want to forget those crashes and the incidents that took them out of context. Let's look back at some of this action. Some great action here today. Amazing to see these riders and the crowds enjoying themselves in Aalen. Don't forget to catch up with our next episode on the way through as well, because this has been an amazing day's racing here today in Aalen. We look forward to seeing the next of the rounds. So from me, Matt Payne, here live in Aalen, thank you for watching. Make sure you catch up with the next round of the UCI World Cup XEE.